Let's take a look at Loudsplit, one of Bitwig Studios' spectral devices. Now, most audio processors look at signal the way our audio files look, the way the microphone hears pressure changes over time, or the voltage going to the speakers recreates that up and down movement of signal. It's treating the entire signal as a whole that is just being created together and can be analyzed all in one go. Spectral devices are different. The audio coming in, the signal coming in, is broken into thousands of frequency bands, which can then be analyzed individually and used in completely different ways. So, where the amplitude analogy here for something loud might be the compressor. It sees any moment of a signal, depending on its threshold, and says, if it's above that threshold, this moment is loud. If it's below that threshold, this moment is quiet. And then it can do things like have a different ratio for how the signal is processed, have a time for attacking into that gain reduction and releasing it, and then, of course, making it up. Now, in the spectral domain with Loudsplit, every moment has loud, middle, and quiet sounds, because every moment has individual frequency bands that fall into one of those categories, which can then be regrouped onto these channels and provide simple audio-friendly mixer controls. The structure is relatively simple. There's just two thresholds, an upper threshold that says anything above this threshold will fall into the loud group, and we'll place it there for you. Anything falling below the lower threshold, listen, will fall into the quiet group. And anything landing in between these two thresholds will be in the mid group for medium volume. Now, what's a little tricky with the spectral devices is, by default, all of these parameters are flat. Unity gain, no panning. It's essentially a reconstruction of the signal. If it was mixed totally dry, you hear the same thing. So it helps when dealing with the spectral devices to make some kind of audio change in the signal before you start playing with the parameters, because then you'll really hear what's happening, whether that's a volume change or panning the different signal groups differently, or even inserting Bitwig devices or plugins to process them individually. In addition, on these thresholds, each one also has a knee setting of its own, which allows a width to be defined, essentially a crossfade period. So now, instead of just yellow for mid and red for loud, we're seeing orange, because signals falling within this knee are actually occurring on both sides, on both bins as they transition. And before we even get there to the knee, there is also a rise and fall parameter. Rise saying how much time should a signal have to linger in a louder bin before it is allowed to cross in. Kind of a resistance parameter. So this will greatly slow down something trying to make its way in, because it has to stay on this side of the threshold for quite a while. And for signals on the way down, a fall parameter saying how long should it take for this signal to lose the gain that it had. So in this case, we're soloing. So if we set a long fall time, how many frames for each thing that just peaks over that threshold before it's returned all the way back to zero, since soloing is all the way on? kind of have a spectral reverb already without inserting any plugins, any devices, not even any gain change. Just saying, only play this bin and let us ring out for a bit. Additionally, there is a relative loudness mode because sometimes it's more useful to have kind of an auto-normalize function. Now, each frame of sound, you're just grabbing the top fraction, the loudest fraction of signal in the loud portion, or in the mid portion, or in the quiet portion. So it kind of automatically tracks the level, which can be useful in some instances. Now, we've got these parameters, and one more that we'll bring up in a minute. What could we do? How about, let's try to make a nice thin band of signal in the middle. So if we put these very close together, we're just trapping things that land for this brief moment. We could even give them a little more resistance, or even a super quick fall off to kind of land in an artifacty zone. Now, I want to take this tiny strand of signal and actually make it predominate, make it ring out over the rest of the signal, because it's nice to have these little moments and emphasize them. So, what extravagant processing? Maybe the simplest thing, a tool device, just to do massive gain change, to bring this up nice and big, and then to smooth it out a little, maybe a delay plus, with some feedback and some built-in feedback effect. Would be nice. It's a little extreme. And that last parameter, the purple as our most analysis parameters, allowing us to tilt the spectrum in the analysis portion. So now we can make the high part ring out a little bit more. Or tilt it all towards the low portion of the spectrum predominating. So, just a little bit of what's possible with some of the spectral devices here in Bitwig Studio. Thanks for joining us. See you again next time.